गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वी आर स्टार्टिंग टुडे विथ आवर सेकेंड ईयर अकाउंटेंसी सब्जेक्ट। वी विल कॉल द फर्स्ट अकाउंटिंग सब्जेक्ट नेम्ड एज सिंगल एंट्री सिस्टम। इट इज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन आवर अकाउंटेंसी फॉर द सेकेंड ईयर इंटरमीडिएट कोर्स। Okay, so before we start with our single entry system, we'll refresh our first year knowledge of accountancy, like what is mean by accounting, what is mean by bookkeeping, what is the objects of accountancy, what are the features of accountancy, and how a bookkeeping should be maintained when you do the business transactions. Okay. So accounting, first, accounting is a development, what we have seen in the 17th century for the development of commerce and trade. Okay, so the accounting is called as a language of business, where we are going to do so many business transactions, but there is no proper language to express the movement of money, the recording of the transactions in a business. So a subject called as an accounting has been developed. In a modern world, accounting has been treated as an important communication system between the buyer and seller. So accounting means it is the process of recording, summarizing, identifying, analyzing those transactions which can be expressed in the terms of money or money's worth. We will call that as accounting. So accounting will help us in a business to know what is the profit made by the business. Accounting will help you in the business to analyze what is the properties earned by the business, how much is the money borrowed from the business from the outside. So accounting will be done on the basis of identifying the transaction. The important terms, how you are going to do accounting in the business: identifying, analyzing, summarizing, and recording those transactions which can be expressed in the process of money or money's worth. In order to know what is the position of the business, we will use accounting. So accounting is mainly based on two methods, or we can call this as two systems also. So one is called double entry system, which you have already studied in first year accounting. Double entry system. Next one is called single entry system. So before we go to explain what is mean by double entry system and single entry system, I want to give you a little bit clarification about the terms what we will be using in our accounting definition. First one we will call as a transaction. Transaction means it is a movement of money, or it is a movement of goods, or it is a movement of services from one person to another person, which will help you to analyze what is the change occurring in your financial position. We will call that as a transaction. So second one we will call identification. Identify the transaction, whether it is a business related transaction or non-business related transaction. Every transaction will be expressed either in the monetary terms or either in the non-monetary terms. The transactions which are expressed in monetary terms, we will identify them in into receiving aspect or giving aspect, which we are going to call them as a debit or credit. So analyze those, analyze those transactions which are going to give effect on your financial positions. So there will be a numerous transactions incurred by the business every day. So every transaction may not be useful for the business, or every transaction cannot be in a process of expanding in a lengthier form. So we will write that in a shortcut, we will call that as a summarizing. Then we will go to report those transactions properly in whether it is an income, payment, asset or liability, whether we have purchased or whether we have taken the benefit or whether we have given the benefit. Depending upon that, those transactions will be treated into our accounting and we will take the decision related to the business. Okay, so mainly our accounting has two methods, or we can call them as a two systems. One system is called double entry system and another one is called as a single entry system. So double entry system means it is a most famous and nowadays it is being used in every area and every place where the business has its account, has kept its accounting books. They will follow the recording of the business transactions only under the double entry system. So double entry system is the system of recording the transactions of the business in a systematical manner, dividing the transactions according to the principles of accounting, that is debit and credit. When a transaction in a business is recorded systematically according to the principles of debit and credit rule, we will call that as double entry system. Under the double entry system, every transaction has two aspects. These two aspects we will call that as a debit aspect and credit aspect. Debit aspect means receiving aspect, credit aspect means giving aspect. So according to the double entry system, a transaction will take place between two people. A transaction will take place between two people. One we will call as a receiver, another one we will call it as a giver. Every person who is receiving the benefit will be called as a receiver, and the person who is giving the benefit is called as a giver. Receiver aspect will be treated as a debit aspect and giver aspect will be treated as a credit aspect. According to this system, a transaction will take place between two people, one customer and one business, or between one business and another business, or between the firm and the business. So according to this system, every debit will have the credit, equal and opposite credit. So suppose if I am buying the machinery of 50,000, buying the machinery of 50,000. If I am buying the machinery of 50,000, 50,000 worth of cash will go from business and 50,000 worth of machinery will come into the business. So machinery is an asset for the business. My asset position will increase, whereas cash is going out of the business, my cash balance will decrease. So there is equally, cash is going out of the business but machinery is coming into the business. So 50,000 value of the machine is coming, whereas the 50,000 value of your cash is going out of the business. So your debit Machinery is the property for the business. We cannot do any type of business unless until you have the property with you or assets with you. But to buy these assets or to buy these properties in the business, we need the cash or we need someone to give you some money in the form of borrowing. So we are buying machinery worth 50,000. We are getting the machinery into the business 50,000. Cash is going equal amount 50,000 from the business. So cash is going out of the business, machinery is coming into the business up to the equal mark. So we call this as a double entry system. That means it is a metered system of recording the transactions in the business where every debit is equal to credit. So we don't have any type of unequalness or we don't have any type of mismatching the figures. So it is one of the important concepts in accounting principles, that is a dual aspect concept. Every debit should have an equal and corresponding amount of credit. Generally, every business organization will prepare their profit and loss account and balance sheet every year at the end of its financial year. That may be a calendar year or that may be a financial year starting from April to March. A small organization like a sole proprietor or small organizations which they don't maintain the books of accounts, like you can call general stores, medical stores, kirana stores or street stores or small type of business units where there is no proper set of accounts will be maintained. These people, they will ascertain the profit and loss of the business by following a method called as single entry system method of keeping the books of records. So single entry system is another system alternative to the double entry system. Double entry system is a system of recording the transactions of a business in a systematical manner, in a metered manner, where they are going to follow the rules of where they are going to follow the principles of debit and credit. So double entry system is a system of recording the transactions of a business according to the principles of accountancy, where the results are accurate. But when you go to the single entry system, it is an inaccurate, it is an unsystematic and unmetered system of recording the transactions of business. But every businessman will have a common objective, how to find out the profit earned by him in every accounting period. Some people will ascertain the profit or loss of the business by using the techniques of single entry system, like taking the capital at the beginning of the year and taking the capital at the end of the year. They are going to find out the difference as a profit. Okay, so because they are not recording the transactions of a business in a systematical manner, in an accurate manner, so arithmetical accuracy will not exist in finding the profits. Because as per the double entry system, every transaction in the business has double effect, debit effect as well as credit effect. But in case of single entry system, a transaction is not recorded
one side of the transaction. Either we will record the debit aspect or either we will record the credit aspect of the transaction. That means one of the side of the transaction will be ignored or totally it is kept away from the recording the transaction. So the finding of the profit is not made by the way of double entry system because both the sides of the transaction is not recorded. We are going to record only one side. That will not help you to find out the profit or to prepare the balance sheet of the business. So we will use our techniques or we will use our logics or we will use our small mathematical calculations to find out the profit or loss. So if you take example in our double entry system, we will prepare profit and loss account. This is done by the way of preparing like this. We'll prepare the trading account. From the trading account, we'll bring forward the gross profit and we will take all the type of expenses here. Finally, you will ascertain net profit because every transaction here will be recorded twice. Okay, but when you go to the single entry system, we cannot go like this because the transaction is ignored or the proper set of accounts, that is, you are not maintaining the nominal account properly. Nominal account means all the type of expenses, incomes, gains and losses will not be maintained in the accounting by keeping the books on accounts. Real accounts, that means all the assets, accurate value or the proper value cannot be maintained. Then we are keeping only some part of the transaction. Either we may be having capital at the beginning or we may be having capital at the end. With the help of these capitals, we are going to prepare the profit and loss or we are going to ascertain the profit what the businessman has made when he is not keeping the proper set of books of account. With the help of this capitals, sometimes a businessman may maintain personal accounts like debtors account, debtors account, creditors account. So he will ascertain what is the amount he has to get from the business, what is the amount he has to pay to the other type of business. Normally we will follow this method in finding the profit according to single entry system. So calculation of profit or loss under single entry system. First we will start with the capital at the end of the year. Capital at the end of the year. Normally, the capital at the end of the year will be calculated by the businessman depending upon his financial calendar. That may be some people will follow the financial year or some people will follow the calendar year. If it is a calendar year, we'll take it on 31st of December, or if it is a calendar financial year, we'll take on 31st of March. For this, we will add drawings made during the year. Drawings made during the year. What is the amount that a businessman has drawn either in the form of goods or either in the form of cash from the business for the whole accounting year? We will add to the capital at the business. We will get some result. From that we are going to minus or deduct fresh or additional capital introduced which we got by adding to the capital at the end. The result what you are going to get, we will call that as a net adjusted capital. The result what you are going to get after doing the adjustments for the capital at the end will be termed as net adjusted capital. So from that net adjusted capital, we will minus what is the capital at the beginning of the year. That may be on 1st of January or 1st of April if the dates are specified by the businessman. So we will take it here, and the result what you are going to get will be called as net profit or net loss depending upon the net adjusted capital. If the net adjusted capital is more when compared to capital at the end of the year, we will call that as a net profit. And if the net adjusted capital is less when compared to capital at the beginning, we will call that as net loss. So before we start with the some of the things of single entry system, we will discuss what are the features of the single entry system, what is advantages of single entry system and demerits of single entry system. So first we will start with features of single entry system. So we are going to start with the features of single entry system. So before we start with the explanation for the features of single entry system, once again I will revise what is the meaning of single entry system. Single entry system is not at all a system of recording the transactions of a business in a systematical manner or a scientific manner. It is in an inaccurate, unscientific and unsystematical method of recording the transactions of a business without following the principles of double entry system. According to the single entry system, a transaction will not be recorded or divided into debit and credit form, that is receiving aspect of the transaction and giving aspect of the transaction will totally not be recorded. Either we will record the debit aspect or either we will record the credit aspect, but both the aspects of the transaction will not be recorded because the business is not maintaining any type of records or accounts. In single entry system, a business will not keep all the types of accounts like personal accounts, real accounts and nominal accounts. They will maintain only personal accounts like debtors and creditors. A part of the cash transactions will be recorded, but they are going to ignore the accounts called as nominal account. Since all the accounts are not maintained under the single entry system, we can call this type of an accounting also as a accounts from incomplete record. So one of the important methods of finding the profit made under a single entry system, because for every problem we have a certain solution. In a double entry system, we are recording the transaction debit and credit. We are telling what is the receiving and what is the giving. We have a procedure, we have a system how to find out the profit made under the double entry system. Because here we are not keeping any type of records. Since the accounts are incomplete, they are not scientifically recorded. Then the transactions are not recorded in a proper manner. Arithmetical accuracy cannot be ascertained in single entry system. But for every problem, solution will be there. So we will find out the profit made by the business in a simplest form given by an accounting. That We will take the capitals of the business. What is the capital invested by the businessman at the beginning of the accounting period as well as at the end of the accounting period, and we will find out the profit or loss made by a businessman. So single entry system is nothing but the mixture of double entry system and single entry system is not there. The entry of transaction is not there. That is called as a single entry system. So some of the important features of a single entry system First one, inaccurate. Inaccurate means unknown, not correct, without giving any guarantee for whatever you are doing the work. It is 100% pakka or 100% scientific. We call such a word as inaccurate. The normal tendency of a human being when you do the business is whatever the transactions, whatever the business you are doing, for that we are going to keep a record. By recording the transactions of a business in a systematical manner, in a scientific manner, by keeping that records, the final result, what you calculate, what you get, that should be a 100% should have arithmetical accuracy to present that records in front of someone. But when you go to single entry system, we don't have any type of recording of the transactions done here. We are not recording any transaction. We are not keeping any books of accounts. We are not maintaining any type of arithmetical accuracy, and we cannot give. This is a 100% confident, reliable, and acceptable accounting procedure. Then second one, personal accounts only are maintained. In case of single entry system, we'll keep only personal accounts. Personal account means like debtors. Debtors means customers. We'll record in one book at one place. When we do credit sales, we'll put that amount we have to receive from such a so person on so and so day. We will write in that book. When you get that money, we are going to either strike out that amount or either we'll take that paper itself. But we will not show again the transaction affected anywhere else in our accounting. So that will only help you what is the investment you have done in purchasing and selling. So both debtors and creditors are both our personal accounts. So we will use this only for finding out our profits. So in a single entry system, they maintain only personal account. They don't maintain any type of a real account and nominal account. No nominal account. Nominal account means according to the double entry system. Nominal account stands for all the transactions of a business related to incomes, gains, losses and expenses. They are not kept in this businesses. So it is impossible. We cannot rely on that system. Next, no recording of transactions. It is a simple, easy to calculate the profit. Because there is no recording of the transactions of the business in the single entry system, so we don't have any proof evidences to show. Then this type of a single entry system will be followed by only those people who are doing small size businesses like kirana stores, medical stores, sweet shops, or we have a small electrical stores or general stores. So this single entry system of maintaining the accounts is done only by those people whose capital investment in the business is very less, who don't have any proper accounting knowledge or don't have any type of intention of keeping the records of accounts. Okay, so till now we have been understanding the features of single entry system. Now we will understand what all the merits or advantages for those business organizations which don't follow the double entry system but they are following the single entry system. How can we understand the benefits given to us by a
single entry system. First one, simple method. In case of single entry system, there is no specific method of finding the profit and loss. It's the simplest method, easiest method given made by a businessman to find out the profit or loss made by the business organization. Profit and loss can be ascertained easily, our second advantage. In a double entry system, we are going to find out the profit and loss by going to prepare separately trading account if it is a trading concern. We are going to prepare the manufacturing account if it is a manufacturing concern. Then we will go to the profit and loss. But when you go to the profit and loss, what type of expenses, losses should be considered and how we are supposed to find out the profit, how we have to find out the balance, how we have to prepare the balance sheet will become a little bit difficult part. But when you come to a single entry system, a person who does not have a minimum basic knowledge of accountancy, like professional knowledge, expert knowledge, or who doesn't have the knowledge of commerce also, can easily able to ascertain profit or loss made by the business in this method. Then next one, less expensive. When you go for a single entry system, we don't have a proper system of keeping the records, files or documents, or we don't have any type of maintaining the system for the every year or every successive year's accounting periods. So the expenditure what you are incurring in keeping the records like files, purchasing the documents, purchasing the files, purchasing the stationery, appointing the accountant, assistants, maintaining the computer accounts. So expenditure incurred by a business at the time when you go for preparing accounts under the double entry system. A accountant should have an expert knowledge. He should have the knowledge of cost accounting, management accounting, some of the forms of income tax, some of the business laws which we will use in our regular life. These all cost a very much high expensive to a businessman if he is going to opt for the double entry system. But when it is a single entry system, it is a small organizations which are going to opt for the single entry system because they are not having that much cost expensive to pay for the professionals to write the books of accounts. So the expenditure incurred in maintaining the accounts under the single entry system is very less. Easy to understand. See this pro forma. The way we are going to calculate the profit or loss under the single entry system, anyone who is having a basic or minimum knowledge of bookkeeping can easily understand. So he does not misunderstand or going to have any type of confusion or cumbersome in making the things easier for him to calculate the profit. Then the last one, no principles are to be followed. So we are not going to follow the principles of double entry system, debit, credit, or we are not going to show here receiving aspect, giving aspect. We are not going to draw any type of a pro forma, particular amount or anything else. We are doing just like a simple calculation how a normal household person is going to do. So simple form of accounting done by a small organizations where the capital investment is very less and they don't have a minimum accounting knowledge also, they can opt for a simple way of calculating the net profit, net loss. Such a method is called as a single entry system.